So in today's class, we are going to discuss the topic of mensuration. And in mensuration, we are going to discuss perimeter and area of 2D figures. Perimeter and area of 2D figures. Now, what type of figures? We are going to look at the perimeter and area of quadrilaterals, triangles, and circles. And in this chapter, the next thing that we are going to move on to is the surface area and volume of solids. Now, when I say solids, it's a three-dimensional shape. So the figures that we are going to cover are cube and cuboid. We are going to look at prisms, cylinders, cone, pyramid, and sphere. These are the shapes that we are going to do. So let's start with the perimeter and area. Perimeter and area of 2D figures. The first shape that we are going to discuss is a parallelogram. In a parallelogram basically looks like this. That has two sides parallel, two opposite sides parallel, but they are not 90 degrees to each other. This side is parallel to this side is parallel to that side, okay? So if we talk about the perimeter of the shape, perimeter is just the length of the path, length of all sides, outer boundary. So if this is A and this is B, perimeter is good. Well, if this is A, the sides are opposite and parallel, so this should also be A. The two sides are parallel, so if this is B, this should also be B units. So if you add all these sides, the perimeter is going to be 2A plus 2B, and you can take two common. So the other way of writing, the perimeter is 2 times A plus B. Now, as far as the area of the parallelogram is concerned, this is the vertical height, and to find the area, you just multiply the length, the base length, which is this, times the height, which is H. So, BH. That is the area of the parallelogram. Okay, right now I'm just doing shapes. I want you to note this down and then we can look at questions. Anything that is not clear over here?
No, sir.
The next shape is rhombus. A rhombus is also a pair of opposite sides, opposite and equal sides. But in rhombus, all the sides are equal. So these two sides are parallel. These two sides are parallel, but all of the sides are of the same length. Okay. So perimeter is, for this figure, it's just going to be all the sum of all the sides, that is 4a. You add all the sides. And as far as the area is concerned, it's the same thing. If you know the perpendicular height from this point, let's say, to the base, and you know the base, you can just multiply the base with the height. So area for this as well is the base times the height. I mean, you could also write BH, it doesn't matter. ठीक है. Right now over here, the length that I have denoted as A, that's why A times the perpendicular height. Remember, this height and these height must be perpendicular. Also, the area can also be written as half. If this is ABCD rhombus, and we know that AC is the diagonal of the rhombus, BD is the diagonal of the rhombus. So if you know the length of the diagonals, you can just multiply the length of the diagonals. AC times BD times by half. You can also use this as the area formula. Okay. Have you noted this down?
No, sir, I'm still noting it down.
Okay. The next shape that we are going to discuss is the trapezium. A trapezium looks like this. You have two sides parallel. They may not necessarily be equal. And the other two sides are not parallel. So this is known as the trapezium. If you drop a perpendicular height, if you drop a perpendicular line to the base, then this is the height of the trapezium. If I'm naming this side as B and this side as, let's say, C, then the, okay, and if you somehow manage to find this side and this side, so the perimeter is just nothing but the length, the total length of the path, the total of all the sides. So perimeter is nothing but A plus B plus C plus D. But for the area of the trapezium, the formula is half times sum of parallel sides times height. Trapezium pe bahut questions aate hain. So half times sum of parallel sides, the two sides that are parallel are ye C or ye B. So B plus C times the height, which is H. तो ये फॉर्मूला यूज हो जाएगा टू फाइंडिंग दी फॉर फाइंडिंग दी एरिया ऑफ द ट्रेपेजियम. ओके, द नेक्स्ट फिगर इन लाइन इज द रेक्टेंगल.
सर आपकी आवाज कट गई थी बीच में.
ओके, इज इट क्लियर नाउ?
यस.
ओके, आई एम गोना रिपीट दिस द वे टू फाइंड द पेरिमीटर एंड द एरिया ऑफ द ट्रेपेजियम. For the perimeter of the trapezium, you can just add all the lengths if you know. So A plus B plus C plus D. And for the area of this trapezium, the trapezium area is given by half times sum of parallel sides times the perpendicular height between the two parallel sides. So half times the parallel sides are C and B units. So C plus B times the perpendicular height, that is H. Okay. The next figure that we are going to discuss is rectangle. Now in rectangle, we in previous classes we have done the geometrical properties of all the quadrilaterals. So we have done the properties of rectangle. Now we are just looking at what is going to be the perimeter and the area. So these two sides are parallel, these two sides are parallel to each other, and they are also equal. The perimeter is nothing but the sum of all the sides. So if this is A, this is going to be A, this is B, this is going to be B. So 2 times A plus B. The area for a rectangle is nothing but length times width keh lo ya breadth keh lo. So length is A, width is B. So it's the product of the length and the width. Okay. The next shape is a square. In square, all the lengths are same. So the perimeter is equal to the sum of all the lengths, so 4L, and the area is simply length, this length times this length, that is L square. Then for triangle, let's say we have this type of triangle. In which all the lengths are different. It's triangle ABC, A, B, and C. This is the perpendicular height of the triangle. The perimeter is nothing but the sum of all the sides. So perimeter is going to be A plus B plus C, and the area is going to be half times base times height. Ye area ka formula hota hai. So in this, with respect to this example, if I am dropping a perpendicular line over here, I'm dropping it to this base, at this base. So the base is, as per this question, is going to be C, and the height is going to be H. So the general formula is half into base into height. You can remember this. Also, the other formula could be that if you know any angle, let's say theta, so, or as to say, if you know this angle along with these two lengths, this length and this length, if you know two sides and an inclusive angle, you can still find the area by using half times AB sine of angle C. ठीक है, अब अगर ये वाला एंगल गिवन है और ये दो साइड्स गिवन है, तब भी आप एरिया फाइंड कर सकते हैं. आपके पास ये वाली लेंथ तो ये वाली लेंथ गिवन है, ये एंगल गिवन है, तब भी आप एरिया फाइंड कर सकते हैं. और अगर आपके पास परपेंडिकुलर हाइट गिवन है और ये बेस गिवन है, तब भी आप हाइट एरिया फाइंड कर सकते हैं. बट द शेप डज नॉट चेंज. बाई यूजिंग डिफरेंट फॉर्मूला फॉर द सेम डायमेंशन ऑफ द ट्राइंगल, द area will not change, the area is going to be same. So the answer as a product of half into C into H is going to be equal to half into AB sin C, because it represents the area of the same triangle with the same dimensions. Is this part clear?
Yes.
The rectangle PQRS measures 12 centimeter by 8 centimeter. Point T, U, V, and W are on the sides with the measurements in centimeters as shown. Find the area in square centimeters of T, U, V, W. T, U, V, W. Iska hame area nikalna hai. Find also the height H of the parallelogram T, U, V, W. So the question says that this T, U, VW is a parallelogram. ठीक है. Right now we want to find the area of this parallelogram. So let's take an azan break for 2 minutes and then start. So in this question we have the measurement of the rectangle, that is 12 centimeter by 8 centimeter. So that means that from S to R, the length is 12 centimeter. From Q to R, the length is 8 centimeter. Also, PS is going to be 8, and PQ is going to be 12 centimeter. Now, what should be my thought process? I know it's a parallelogram, और मुझे parallelogram का area निकालना पता है कि it's base into height. But ना तो मेरे पास ये base है WT, और ना ही इसकी perpendicular height है. ठीक है, तो सबसे पहले मैं क्या कर सकता हूं, यू कैन फाइंड द एरिया ऑफ अ पैरेललोग्राम विदाउट फाइंडिंग एच एज वेल फर्स्ट बाय कंसिडरिंग पी क्यू आर एस एज रेक्टेंगल एज अ कंप्लीट आउटसाइड रेक्टेंगल एंड देन टेकिंग आउट द एरियाज of individual triangles. So, jab triangles ke areas aa jayenge, usko rectangle ke area se if you subtract, you are going to get an area of the parallelogram. Is this concept clear?
Yes.
Okay. So, sabse pehle, let's find the length of PT. PT and this length PT and VR are going to be same. And that is going to be 12 minus 3, that is 9 centimeter, which means that we have this value as 9 centimeter and this value as 9 centimeter. अब अगर ये 9 centimeter है और इसकी height यहाँ पे PW की 2 है और इसकी भी 2 है, that means इसका area और इसका area same होगा, ठीक है? इसी तरीके से let's find QU. QU and SW are going to be same. 8 minus 2, that is 6. So this length is 6 and this length is 6. ठीक है? So if this triangle, right angle triangle has this length is 6 and 3 and the same goes for this triangle TQU, then the areas of the triangle 3 and 4 must be same. So, to find the area of TUVW, what I can do is I can take the area of the entire PQRS, pure rectangle ka area, minus 2 times the area of triangle, area of triangle PWT minus 2 times the area of triangle TQU. Okay, now I want you to plug in the values and give me the value. So, area of PQRS should be simply length into width, because rectangle is 12 into 8, minus 96. 2 times the area of the triangle PWT. PWT ka area hoga simply half into base into height, 9 into 2, minus 2 times area of triangle TQU, half into 3 into 6. So if you resolve this, you should be getting, this is 18, this is also 18. So 96 minus 18 minus 18 is 60 centimeter square. Yeh aapka area aa jayega. Theek hai? Ab jab aapke paas, very good. Ab jab aapke paas area aa jayega, so parallelogram ki height nikalna mushkil nahi hai, kyunki aapke paas parallelogram ka area aa gaya hai. Theek hai? Ab you want to find the height, and by using Pythagoras theorem, you can find this base. The base is going to be TW, ya WT, jo bhi kehna hai. To find the base WT, I'll have to use the Pythagoras theorem. WT serves as a hypotenuse in the triangle PWT. So ye right angle triangle yahan pe ban raha hai, kyunki rectangle tha. So PWT square is going to be equal to PT square plus PW square. So WT is going to be square root of PT ki value hai 9 square, PW ki value 2 square. So Nawal, what is the value? Square root of 9 square plus 2 square. Exact form mein bata dena. 9 square is 81, so square root of 85.
85 square.
Square root of 85, good. Now for area of the parallelogram, area of TUVW is simply base into height. So WT ki length hai square root of 85 मल्टीप्लाई बाय हाइट दैट इज अननोन, और एरिया की क्या वैल्यू आई थी हमारे पास 60. सो हाइट कैन बी कैलकुलेटेड फ्रॉम हियर, 60 डिवाइडेड बाय स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ 85 दैट कम्स आउट टू बी
6.5.
ओके, थ्री सिग्निफिकेंट फिगर्स में कोशिश करो आंसर को. So it is going to be roughly
6.51
yeah centimeter. ठीक है. The next shape that we are going to look at is circle. Now in circle we are going to be finding the circumference of a circle and the area of the circle. The circumference is the outer boundary, the length of the outer boundary. It's not a straight line, it's a curve. So we are going to find this circumference and the area. Acha. But to find these two things, we need the radius. So what is the radius? A radius, every circle has a center O, okay? Center, koi bhi naam rakh sakte ho, but the center of the circle is going to be known as the origin. And if you connect this dot, the center, with the circumference, this length is the radius. Okay. So to find the circumference, we need the radius of the circle. The circumference of a circle is given by the formula 2 times pi times r. I'm going to use small r, 2 pi r. And the area of the circle, as you know, is pi r squared. Okay. You can get the value of pi from the calculator as well if the question demands. If the question says taking pi value to be 3.142, so you are going to use that value. If the question says take pi as 22/7, you are going to do as the question says. If nothing is mentioned, take the calculator value for paper 2. If the question says leave your answer in terms of pi, do not solve for pi, just leave the answer in terms of pi. For example, if the radius was 3, the circumference would be 6 pi. Is form ko hum kehte exact form. अगर क्वेश्चन कहता है लीव योर आंसर इन एग्जैक्ट फॉर्म, सो यू आर गोइंग टू लीव द आंसर इन टर्म्स ऑफ पाई, यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू गिव योर आंसर इन फ्रैक्शंस और डेसिमल्स. ठीक है, नाउ मूविंग ऑन. अच्छा, वन मोर थिंग यू शुड नो इज, यू नो व्हाट्स डायमीटर, राइट? अगर मैं रेडियस को डबल कर दूं, सो आई एम गोइंग टू गेट द डायमीटर. सो डायमीटर is basically twice of the radius. AB is a diameter. Now this line AB is the diameter because it passes through the center of the circle as well. So how many diameters can this circle have? That you can, along the circumference, you can make infinite lines that are going to pass through the center. Even this line is also going to be called the diameter of a circle. But if I join A and D, this line is not the diameter. This line is going to be known as the chord of a circle. The difference between the chord and the circle and the diameter is that the diameter passes through the center of a circle, but the chord does not pass through the center of a circle. The diameter also touches the circumference at two points. The chord also touches the circumference at two points, but that chord does not pass through the origin, through the center of the circle, not the origin, the center of the circle. Okay, moving on. Now you must understand that the difference between the major sector and the minor sector. So if I divide the circle in such a way that you get two parts, imagine the size, the slice of a pizza. So if the entire pizza was split into two parts, this is going to be the major part and this is going to be the minor part. Now, how are we classifying them as minor and major? The one with the lesser area is the minor sector. And the one with the major area is the major sector. If the area of the minor sector is less, obviously the angle subtended by this arc is also going to be less as compared to the outer angle. You can see that the outer angle is more, that's why the area would be more, and hence it is known as the major sector. For this minor sector, the area is less, hence the angle is also less, or you can say vice versa, the angle is less, so the area is also less. This is known as the length of the arc length of the minor arc. If I mark the points A and B, A and B are not straight. A and B is not a straight line. A and B is the curve, this curve length. This is known as the length of minor arc. And if I consider this length, this length is also AB, curve length of AB, and is known as the length of major arc. ठीक है
सर, आप एक और दफा समझा देंगे मेजर आर्क माइनर आर्क?
श्योर, मुझे कहाँ से समझाना है?
मेजर सेक्टर से जो आपने समझाया था.
या मैं ये कह रहा था कि अगर मैं एक पिज़्ज़ा को दो पार्ट्स में डिवाइड करता हूँ, ठीक है, सो यू कैन सी, यू कैन ऑब्जर्व ओवर हियर इन द डायग्राम दैट दिस पार्ट इज मच लेस देन द आउटसाइड पार्ट. सो the reason being that the angle is less, okay, ye oa and ob are the radius. Since the angle is less, that the area is also going to be less. So area less hai to we call it minor sector. Iska area zyada hai bahar wale ka to we call it a major sector. Ye jo length ban rahi hai minor sector mein circumference pe, उसे आप कहेंगे लेंथ ऑफ द माइनर आर्क. और ये जो लेंथ बन रही है मेजर सेक्टर में, इसे आप कहेंगे लेंथ ऑफ द मेजर आर्क. सही है यहाँ तक?
जी सर.
ओके, अब सिमिलरली दिस इज द एरिया ऑफ मेजर सेक्टर, क्योंकि ये मेजर सेक्टर है तो इसका एरिया एरिया ऑफ मेजर सेक्टर कहलाएगा. एंड दिस इज एरिया ऑफ माइनर सेक्टर. तो हमने सेक्टर्स डिसाइड कर लिए. नाउ इट्स नॉट द केस दैट देर आर ओनली टू सेक्टर्स, एक माइनर है एक मेजर है. यू कैन डिवाइड द सर्कल इनटू मेनी पार्ट्स, इनफाइनाइट पार्ट्स हो सकते हैं, ठीक है. So you may get a question in which the circle is divided into three parts. So there are going to be three sectors, four parts, four sectors. Yani ki, for example, if I divide the circle into four equal parts, would you agree that I'm going, that if this was my pizza slice, if I divide the circle into four equal parts, everyone will have an equal share of pizza?
Yes.
ठीक है. एंड दैट इज बिकॉज द एरिया इज द सेम, एरिया ऑफ एवरी स्लाइस इज द सेम. नाउ द एरिया इज सेम बिकॉज ईच सेक्टर हैज द सेम एंगल एज वेल. सो दैट मीन्स दैट द एरिया ऑफ द सेक्टर डिपेंड्स ऑन द एंगल. सो वी आर गोइंग टू सी हाउ टू फाइंड द एरिया of the sector. Okay, so what was the area of the complete circle?
Pi r square.
If you divide the circle into two parts, let me show you. If you divide the circle into two parts, so two equal parts, can I say that the two areas are equal?
Yes.
The top part is going to be, I mean, both the parts are going to be known as the semicircle. Semicircle means half of circle. So to find the area of this half of the circle, what can I do? I can take the formula for the area of a circle and divide it by 2. Can I do that? Can I divide pi r square by 2 to get the area of the semicircle?
Yes.
So the formula comes out to be 1 upon 2 pi r square. Similarly, if I was at a restaurant and was eating pizza with my four friends, agar maine equal isko divide kiya hai, equally sabko mila hai share of the slice. So if this is the radius of the pizza, so what is going to be the formula for the area of my slice? By the way, this is known as quadrant because it's 1/4 of the entire circle. So if this is 1/4 of the entire circle, would you agree that the area of this slice is also going to be 1/4 of the entire circle, that is pi r square?
Yes.
Okay, just a second. So as I was saying that the area of the quadrant, this quadrant is going to be 1/4 of the entire circle. Okay. Now if I link it to the angle of the sector, if you look at a complete circle, what is the angle of the complete circle? What is the angle of the complete circle? Do you remember it was 360 degree?
Yes, of the whole triangle, of the whole circle, right?
For the whole circle. So if you measure the angle from here, the total angle is going to be 360 degree. So if I ask you, okay, how much of the complete circle does this represent? So you are going to say it's one complete circle. That's why the area is 1 times pi r square, pi r square. But if I take this semicircle and I ask you, you observe that this is half of the complete circle. Okay. So you said that the area is going to be 1 upon 2 times pi r square. Now, if I talk in terms of the angle, the angle is 180 degree for the semicircle. So what proportion is it of the entire circle? If you take 180 degree out of 360 degree, the proportion is going to be the area of this semicircle as compared to area of semicircle, okay, as compared to area of circle, the ratio is going to be 1/2, even the ratio of the angle is 180 upon 360, that is 1/2. So 180 times 1, 180 times 2. So area of semicircle, which is this, comes out to be 1/2 times area of circle. So area of circle is pi r square. Isliye ye formula aata hai. Similarly, if I take the area of this quadrant if I take the ratio of the area of this quadrant over the entire circle, the ratio is going to be the same as the ratio of the angle, that is 90 upon 360. and 90 upon 360 is 1 upon 4, so that's why the ratio comes out to be 1/4 of the area of the circle, that is pi r square. So the point I'm trying to make over here is that if you are ever asked to find area of a sector, you must know the angle of the sector. So you are going to take theta, the angle of the sector, divided by 360 times pi r square. This is going to give you the area of the sector. And similarly, if you are interested in finding the arc length of a sector, so arc length is also in the same ratio as the area, that is theta upon 360 times 2 pi r, because the area of a circle is equal to 2 pi r. Sorry, the circumference of a circle is equal to 2 pi r. So the arc length is also going to be the part of the total circumference. So theta upon 360 times 2 pi r. And if you do not understand this, you can just remember these formulas, just plug in the value of theta and you are going to get the area of the sector. And if you plug in the value of theta over here in this formula, you're going to get the arc length of the circle. Is this somewhat clear? Namal, do you want me to repeat anything?
No, sir.
Okay. So let's move on to one question. If you have two circles like these, this is one circle and this is another circle, and they are, let's say, overlapping something like this. So these are equal circles, okay? And just a second. And they are intersecting in such a way that the two circles pass through the center. So the center of circle number one is this. So this is going to be the radius. And this is the center of this, the second circle. And the radius is equal, that is 6 centimeters. So if I shade this area and I ask you what is the area of the shaded region, how would you do that? These are the two equal circles. Let me write this. Two equal circles having the same, obviously if the two circles are equal, they are going to have the same radius. That is 6 centimeters. So this being the center of the circle one, this being the center of the circle two, if you join the center of the circle with the circumference of the circle, that is the radius. If you join this circle with the circumference of the radius, circumference of the circle, that's the radius. The value is 6 centimeters. Ab aapko shaded region malum karna hai. ठीक है, तो हाउ वुड यू डू सच क्वेश्चंस? देखो, द फर्स्ट थिंग दैट यू आर गोइंग टू डू इज यू अंडरस्टैंड दिस डायग्राम. इफ आई कनेक्ट दिस पॉइंट अलोंग विद दिस पॉइंट ओवर हियर, वुड यू स्टिल कंसिडर दिस टू बी अ रेडियस? कैन आई स्टिल कंसिडर दिस रेड लाइन टू बी द रेडियस? Hello. This is the center, this is the circumference. Can I still consider this to be a radius? Nawal, can you hear me?
Yes, sir, I can.
अच्छा मैं ये कह रहा हूँ कि क्या ये रेडियस होगा?
नहीं सर, ये रेडियस तो नहीं होगा।
ये रेडियस नहीं होगा। अच्छा देखो, क्या रेडियस क्या होता है? सेंटर से आपने सर्कमफ्रेंस को
ये
ज्वाइन कर लिया,
कोर्ड होगा ना?
ये कॉर्ड नहीं होगा। सेंटर
नहीं
से सर्कमफ्रेंस, देखो क्या ये पॉइंट सर्कल वन पे लाई कर रहा है? ये वाला पॉइंट सर्कल वन पे लाई कर रहा है?
नहीं सर, सर्कल टू पे
लेकिन
एक
ये
एंड में
पॉइंट,
आ रहा है। हाँ भाई जी
ये पॉइंट तो दोनों सर्कल्स पे लाई कर रहा है, ये इंटरसेक्शन पॉइंट
जी
से दोनों सर्कल के, तो ये सर्कल वन पे भी लाई कर रहा है, सर्कल टू पे भी लाई कर रहा है। तो अगर ये पॉइंट सर्कल सर्कल वन पे लाई कर रहा है और आप इसको सेंटर से ज्वाइन करो, तो क्या ये कहना सही है कि ये रेडियस होगा?
जी
सही है। अब अगर ये रेडियस है तो मैं इस पॉइंट को अगर सी टू से, सेंटर टू से ज्वाइन करता हूँ, तो ये भी रेडियस है। ठीक है, तो अगर ये भी रेडियस है, इसकी लेंथ भी 6 सेंटीमीटर हो जाएगी, इसकी लेंथ भी 6 हो जाएगी, ये भी 6 है। सो व्हाट टाइप ऑफ ट्राइंगल इज इट?
इक्विलेटरल।
वेरी गुड, इट्स एन इक्विलेटरल ट्राइंगल। सो इक्विलेटरल ट्राइंगल विद ऑल दिस लेंथ एज 6 सेंटीमीटर। एंड वॉट इज द एंगल ऑफ एन इक्विलेटरल ट्राइंगल? ईच एंगल ऑफ एन इक्विलेटरल ट्राइंगल? ईच एंगल ऑफ एन इक्विलेटरल ट्राइंगल इज 60 डिग्री। ठीक है, सो दिस एंगल इज 60 डिग्री। अब वट आई वॉन्ट टू डू इज I want to find this area of the segment first. ये जो area of the ये segment है, इसका area find करना है मुझे। मेरी thought process ये है कि to find the shaded region, ठीक है, to find this the entire shaded region, ये पूरा जो मुझे find करना है, मुझे यहाँ पे ये दो equilateral triangles बन सकते हैं, इनका एरिया फाइंड कर लूं, और ये जो सेगमेंट बन रहे हैं इनका एरिया फाइंड कर लूं, तो मुझे ये टोटल एरिया मिल जाएगा। ठीक है, आर यू गेटिंग दिस?
यस सर।
सो द फर्स्ट थिंग दैट वी आर गोइंग टू डू इज, इफ इफ लेट्स से दिस इज सी टू, तो इसके ऊपर ये आर्क आ रहा है इस तरीके से, सही है। तो मैं ये करूंगा कि आई एम गोइंग टू फाइंड दिस सेगमेंट एरिया फर्स्ट, एंड ये जो सेगमेंट एरिया है दैट्स इक्वल इन ऑल फोर केस, 1 2 3 4, यानी कि ये एरिया, ये एरिया, ये सब इक्वल है। सो टू फाइंड द सेगमेंट एरिया, वुड यू एग्री दैट एरिया ऑफ सेगमेंट, वन सेगमेंट इज गोइंग टू बी इक्वल टू, इक्वल टू एरिया ऑफ वन सेक्टर माइनस द एरिया ऑफ द ट्राइंगल। If I take out the area of this sector और उसमें से ये वाले triangle का area minus कर दूंगा, तो ये area आ जाएगा। ठीक है, so area of the sector किस कैसे find out करूंगा? Area of the sector आप ऐसे find करेंगे, you are going to use the formula for the area of a sector, that was theta upon 360 times pi r square, and area of the triangle जो है यहाँ पे, that is the formula that you are going to use is half AB sin C, क्योंकि आपको दो sides and an inclusive angle given. So theta is 60 degree upon 360. What is the radius, Nawal?
Six centimeter.
Six. So this is the area of the sector minus area of the triangle half times AB sin C. So this length is 6, this length is 6, and this angle is 60 degree. So half into 6 into sine of 60 degree. Okay, Nawal, solve this, please. Give me the final answer.
Say 1 minute.
You said 3.2, right? I'm getting 3.26 centimeter square. Please confirm ki aapka bhi yahi hai. Three significant figures. This is area of one segment.
जी सर के ही आ रहा
है ठीक है नाउ वी हैव फोर ऑफ दिस सो एरिया ऑफ फोर सेगमेंट्स ये जो ऐसे फोर सेगमेंट्स हैं उसके लिए आई हैव टू मल्टीप्लाई दिस बाय फोर सो फोर टाइम्स 3.26 इज सम अबाउट 13.04 सेंटीमीटर स्क्वायर Now, to find the area of the shaded region initially, the shaded region comprises of two equilateral triangles and four segments. So, area of two triangles, jo equilateral triangles there, one triangle has an area of half into 6 into 6 into sine of 60 degree. So, two is going to be equal to 36 sine 60 degree ठीक है 36 sine of 60 कितना होता है
31.2
31.2. Now you are going to add this and this value to get the total area of the shaded region. Total area of the shaded region is going to be 31.2 plus 13.04.
44.24.
3 significant figure mein it is going to be 44.2. centimeter square. This is going to be your final answer. Is it clear?
Yes.
Good.